They're completely different in the sense that during their development, they do work both on paraffin tissue, which is what we usually have for all our patients, but both have their own technologies, they don't have their own gene list. For example, EndoPredict uses RT-PCR platform and 8 genes, whereas Prosigna uses the nCounter nanostring platform and 50 genes. There is not much overlap regarding the numbers, the genes itself. There are only 2 genes in the PAM50 assay that are in the EndoPredict. That's the only overlap. And another difference is that both tests were derived in different cohorts. The training data sets of both tests were completely different. And whereas the EndoPredict test was trained in a cohort of patients with luminal disease treated with endocrine therapy, the Prosigna assay was trained in a cohort of patients with all subtypes, not only luminal disease, and where patients did not receive any adjuvant therapy in the adjuvant setting. So it's a pure prognostic data set. And when they've been tested in different cohorts, they have been tested in also only one trial is in common between the two. The other ones have been tested in different cohorts. But nonetheless, at the end of the day, what the objective is to identify this group of patients with an outstanding outcome. Another difference between the two tests is the fact that the Prosigna assay also provides biology information, provides the subtype, the intrinsic subtype information. So it provides you the ROR, the risk of recurrence of that patient, but at the same time it tells you if that tumor is a luminal A, is a luminal B, is a HER2-rich and a basal-like. This is different from EndoPredict, which is basically a prognostic signature.